Now, I know I'm not supposed to say anything negative about Barack Obama, or those people are going to get mad at me, but listen, why do y'all get mad at me for saying negative stuff about Barack Obama instead of getting mad at Barack Obama for the negative stuff he does? For example, a woman is far along in her term, and she wants to have an abortion. If that abortion doesn't go as planned, Barack Obama says it's okay for the woman to let the child die from neglect.
Well, that's okay, take the baby, set it on the table, let it die. That's Barack Obama. Now, if Obama's willing to let that happen to a child, imagine what he's willing to let happen to you. And you want to implement Obama's health care plan? Margaret Sanger used abortion as a method to bring upon her master race. The master white race, of course. Adolf Hitler dug where Margaret Sanger was coming from. He employed her philosophy and implemented abortion as a method to bring upon his final solution. Margaret Sanger was the founder of the American Birth Control League, which is now Planned Parenthood. Planned Parenthood. That sounds a little bit more benign, doesn't it? Now, Planned Parenthood, which was founded by the bigoted Margaret Sanger, has played its part in the death of over 11 million black babies since 1973. That's genocide. Barack Obama supports Planned Parenthood, and I'm the self-loving Uncle Tom. I'm trying to tell you, black people, the Democrats are not in your corner. They are the party that's been cornering you. Now let's talk about pregnancy between two willing partners. Y'all have sex, girl gets pregnant, guess what? That was no accident. I don't care how much birth control you use, I don't care how many layers of condoms you must have put on, I don't care. If you got pregnant, that was no accident. Why? Because remember, the primary function of sex is to reproduce. If you engage in the acts of sex and you end up pregnant, that was no accident. That was supposed to happen. Now, if you want to call that a mistake, that's fine. But what I don't understand is, why make the child pay by penalty of death by your mistake? Now, I like the way Al Bundy talked about using birth control. He says the pill is a great form of birth control. You take it and you stick it between your knees and you hold them together. Now, if that couple feels like they made a mistake and feel they're not ready to raise that child, then bless that child with a family who's ready and willing to raise that child. And of course, you have some people who say, oh, that's just so cold-blooded. How could you give up a child that way? Wow, man. Is killing the child in the dark more warm and fuzzy? You have some people who say, well, what if the child's going to be born with Down syndrome or a paraplegic or whatnot? Look, y'all, most children are born in a normal state of health. Why would you employ death as a potential event to befall all children just because a small minority of children are born not within the normal state of health? And who is going to pass judgment on that child and decide whether or not they're going to enjoy their life or not? You're pro-choice, remember? Give that child the choice to decide whether or not their life sucks or if their life is good. Retarded people smile a lot more than we do. Now this whole thing about back alley coat hanger abortions happening because there isn't any funding for it, that's a myth. That stuff comes about because the girl is either ashamed, she doesn't want to deal with the scrutiny, or she doesn't want to deal with any of the consequences that come about from an unwanted pregnancy. Now this whole thing about pro-choice, come on y'all, won't y'all just call it what it is? Don't try to tell me that it's the choice for equal pay and all that sort of stuff, because that's not a choice that you make for yourself. That's somebody else coming to the conclusion that you deserve equal pay, which you do. But let's get down to the nitty-gritty. When we're talking about choice, we're talking about choices that we make for ourselves. Which means that the only choice that you guys are talking about is your right to kill a child. So let's call it what it is. It is a pro-choice. It's pro-abortion. But y'all know it's hard to get a movement behind what it actually is. So you sucker the masses. Come on, let's call it what it is. You sucker the masses by giving it a benign name. Pro-choice. Everybody loves choice. Girl power, that's great. I'm with you on that. But where is the empowerment in killing a child? Some people say, well, it's just a spot of blood. What's the big deal? Well, I've always heard that blood is thicker than water, right? And if that's the case, that makes that spot of blood that you refer to it as your family. And some people want to say, well, that fetus doesn't qualify as human because that fetus can't survive outside of the womb. Well, come on, y'all. Barack Obama has already proven to you guys that you can carry a child full term, put it on a table, and that child will still die regardless of how well it's developed. A full term infant has to have intervention in order to survive. Some people say that a child in the womb is nothing more than a parasite. Well, what about the baby that was birthed? When that baby breastfeeds, what would that make that child? That child is feeding off of the host, right? So according to your logic, I guess the children could be like 18 months outside of the womb. That child is still leeching off the parents. Ooh, you gotta kill that little parasite.
I want some money for this Xbox, or I want some money for this and that, whatever. That child is still leeching off the parents. Ooh, you gotta kill that little parasite. See, by your logic, a child could be aborted at any time.
Now, of course, we conservatives are seen as hypocrites because we're pro-life, yet pro-death penalty. Y'all, these two things are not in the same boat. They're not even the same ocean. How y'all can draw a comparison between those two is beyond me. You got people who are interested in protecting the life of a killer, yet are willing to take the life of an innocent, unborn child. When a person commits or is committing murder, they forfeit their right to live. A force of people is coming to kill the population of another territory. You are going to have to send a counterforce to make sure they are stopped. Most likely going to have to kill them in the process to make sure that they don't kill a mass of people. I hate it when people say that fighting for peace is like raping for virginity. Okay, ladies, now if you're one of those who subscribe to that philosophy, listen. What these people are telling you is that even if you're about to get raped, don't fight back. There's never an excuse to fight. Fighting is always unacceptable. See, if you're in a peaceful state and somebody comes to rape you, they are about to upset your state of peace. Are you just gonna lie there and let them do it? Go ahead and rape me. I won't fight back. Fighting is wrong. Fighting for peace is like raping for virginity. Sometimes you have to fight. There is never an excuse to murder, but murder is a reason to kill. Speaking of rape, liberals might actually like this part because this part right here actually causes infights amongst conservatives. I feel that if a woman suffers a rape, I feel that the child should still be allowed to live. Right now, I know someone want to claw my eyes out right now. Women will tell me, well, you get out there and you get raped and you see how you feel afterwards. Why would you wish something like that upon me to prove your point? I would never wish something like that on you to prove a point. Any woman who has been subjected to that has every right to feel hurt, violated. I can't even begin to imagine the things that you would feel after going through something like that. But do you really feel you have the right to exact wrath upon the child? I agree. Chances are you're not going to be in condition to raise that child. As horrible as the situation is, it can still be redeemed. Take that horror and turn it into a blessing. Someone took your power. But you have an opportunity to reclaim it. But how do you want to use this power? Do you want to use the power to exact wrath upon the child? Or do you want to take that power and make that child a blessing to another family? Or make a family a blessing to that child? And believe me, y'all, you know I've taken into consideration, what if it was my wife? And would I be filled with hate? Hell yeah! I would hate the person who did it. I would hate the circumstances. But I can't hate the child. The child didn't do anything. Now, we get made fun of because we say exercise abstinence. Why do we get made fun of for that when everybody knows that it's the only method that works every time it's tried? I was a panty-hunting teenager, boy. I ain't proud of that either. And teenagers, of course, have a lot worse today. You know the spiel, it's only sex, it ain't no big deal. I wish I would have realized, and I want to get kids to realize today, that if it's no big deal, why are you in such a hurry to have it? It's just weird to me that you have a school system that helps these kids have sex. Then they turn around and complain that the schools are overcrowded and they want more of your tax dollars to fix the problem. It's going to get to a point where these high schoolers are sharing classes with their own kids. Seeing each other during passing period. Hi, Mom. Where's Dad? I don't know. We tried to teach abstinence. It's stupid. It doesn't work. We spent too much money on it and spent too much time on it. Good effort. You got all these liberals who put all this energy into these protests and these demonstrations for whatever it is that you want. Wow, if only you put that kind of effort into promoting abstinence. And the truth is, it really wouldn't take all that. All it would really take is you getting out of our way. Now, what's sad is that they have brought upon the problem, refused to implement the education of abstinence as a means to solve the problem, but the liberal Democrats have a better method to solve the problem. What they do is that they take the pregnant child out of school, have the doctor perform an abortion, you know, because we don't want that new little kid coming and adding to the population of the school, and they can do that without that teenager's parents knowing about it.